So after Friday's lecture, one of you asked me, you know, what was the point of mu t? What is it good for anyway? And so I just wanted to give a quick note about what you could actually use mu t for. So we know that dH is equal to cp dt plus mu t dp. So imagine that we're changing the pressure on a compound, and we're not changing the temperature. Well, if we're not changing the temperature, then this term goes away, and we can say dH is equal to mu t dp. So if we increase the pressure from one pressure to another pressure, and that can show us how the enthalpy is going to change. And so if we integrate that, we get delta H. It's the integral going from P1 to P2 of mu t dp. And a mu t might be a function of pressure, or it might be constant. In any case, if we have mu t as a function of pressure, we could integrate it. If it's constant, we could integrate it. Now, why would this matter? This matters because this is true for all the reactants and products in a chemical reaction, which means we could figure out how the delta H for a reaction changes, right? Your textbook gives you numbers to calculate delta H when all the reactants and products are at 1 bar. But very often, you want to run a reaction at high pressure or at low pressure for whatever reason. In some cases, the reaction won't proceed at any appreciable rate at 1 bar, but you have to go at high pressure to get it to work. And you saw this in organic chemistry when you talked about catalytic hydrogenation of hydrogen, using hydrogen. In some cases, industrially, this is done in very high pressures of hydrogen gas. So if you want to know how hot the reaction is going to get, or how much heat's given off, you need to be able to see how delta H is going to change with pressure, and the way to do that is by using mu t. So this is actually a very useful named partial derivative.